What's up, ladies and gentlemen? It's been raining all day. I am so bored, I don't even know what to do with myself. I'm so used to cleaning windows every day, and I love my job. I love cleaning windows. I don't know about y'all, but I love it. And a day without cleaning windows for me is a day like I felt like I haven't hung out with my best friend. I know it may sound strange to some of you, but this is all I have. It's the only thing I'm good at. You think I graduated high school and say I want to be a window cleaner when I grow up? I mean, who does that? I sure don't. But after making my boss all that money, being a manager, seeing those invoices and the amount on some of them, and what he was paying us, and the fact that he never lift a finger, he sat behind the desk in the office. Multi-millionaire, I tell you, multi-millionaire. If I told you half the stuff he had, y'all be like, damn, he was pulling their panties down and robbing them, pretty much. So I worked my way up from being the worst employee to the best employee. And the only reason why that is because I discovered Wagtail. That's right. This whole story, what I'm about to tell you, may sound strange to some of you. But little did I know that innovating tool that I discovered would lay a foundation to where I am today. I don't care how you slice it. I don't care how some of you who come up with the notion of, well, he's successful because of this and that. Basically, the roots of what started all these things that y'all may think is why, the reason why I'm successful. Some people don't think I'm successful, but if you really knew my story, you would see that I became successful. And looking at window cleaning, to some people, it may seem mundane and mediocre and not so extravagant. But you see, what they fail to realize is that when somebody enjoys something, it's the best job in the world. And you see, these 9-to-5 everyday people, they can't fathom the fact of doing something they enjoy. You know why? Because they stuck at a dead-end job, staring at walls in a cubicle, some of them. And these white-collar workers, they in it for the money. All money ain't good money. And if it means this is gonna wear and tear on your health, what you got to do with that money if you ain't got your health? Because you ain't gonna be living long enough to spend it. You feel me? So is that stress? 90-something percent of all health-related issues is due to stress. It puts a wear and tear on your organs and your respiratory system. You better believe that. And if some of you skeptics who think it doesn't, well, let's just put it this way, it don't help. So why not just be happy and enjoy life? Because you know what that does, right? That raises your vibrational state. And when you raise your vibrational state, you're vibrating on a positive, highest level. And it overrides anybody who's vibrating on a low level frequency. When that vibrational state of theirs comes within your whole circumference, it clashes. You feel this. But a lot of you consciously just ignore everything that your body tells you or your feelings tell you. Or what they call your gut. Go back to your roots. Understand those subtle feelings that you feel inside on a subconscious level. I guarantee you, you're going to thank yourself. You're going to love yourself. And you're going to be more confident in yourself. Yeah, I know you see my screen is cracked. I'm going to go off topic a little bit because these truckers be hawking it down the highway, right? carrying all types of crap. So one of these little stones or pebbles hit my windshield in the front and made a little teeny tiny crack. It must have been 1/8 of a millimeter. I mean, it was really, really small. And I said, oh, that ain't gonna do nothing, but I should have gotten that stuff. You know, we live and learn in life, you know? And when you do something that you don't agree or like, you handle yourself accordingly. You don't go off the deep end. You just deal with the task at hand. So I'm not upset, but I turned on the heat, you know? And see, I don't have nobody but myself to blame. Not that trucker. That trucker is doing his job. All right? A stone hit my windshield. Yeah, it's unfortunate. But there was measures and things that I could have taken for not to let that happen. And you know what that is? Get that stuff, that liquid stuff you pour in there, right? You see, I didn't listen to my gut then. And my gut told me to do that. My subconscious told me to do that, but I ignored it because I'm lazy and I don't want to do something that I don't enjoy. Sometimes we may not always have that choice, but your body and your mind and your gut will never steer you wrong. Only you know what's best for you. So if you don't learn to listen to yourself, you'll be by yourself and you won't understand yourself. So I turned on the heat this morning to defrost the windows. Boy, did that mamma jamma spread like it was in a race. I sat there and watched it. I said, good grief. I hit a bump, bam, it went to the right. It took a turn to the right. And you know what? It's probably going to continue to spread all the way to the other side until it has nowhere to go. And am I going to change my windshield? No, I'm going to be hard-headed, not listen to myself again, and just keep driving like this until I get a ticket and get pulled over. Nah, not really. But I got to tell you, as long as it's not in your view, it really would take a butthole of a cop to give you a ticket for that, because it's obstruction of view. And technically, they can give you a ticket, but it's not in my view. You know, but they probably, at best, or at worst, give me a warning. Wagtail laid the foundation to where I am today. You know why? Because it gave me the motivation. You feel me? So, when I first discovered Wagtail, it was like back in 96, 97, somewhere around there. All right. Now, I don't know, I'm not certain when Willie started it, but I think I was talking to Carl Robertson, if those who don't know who he is. And we had a little discussion on the forum about when Willie started it, because he has an original design as well as I do. And it's a very rare design. Someday I'll show y'all. I think I did show y'all before, but he has original design of some tools that I don't have anymore. It broke, some got ran over by a car. My original 36-inch got shut because that's such a long channel. Back then I had a smaller vehicle and that thing just sticks out and sometimes not, you know, after doing the job, you're not paying attention. You shut the trunk on that bama. Or if, let's say you trying to go into business. Well, this is really what happened. I was trying to go into business with a few friends. Big mistake. Big mistake. Some of you who are thinking that now, you better rethink that. But needless to say, you know, we're in and out of the trunk. We're doing all the jobs together, splitting all the jobs together. He's breaking off on one side of the street, handing out flyers, postcards, business cards, like wildfire, right? And so am I. We managed to drum up enough work to make a nice little something something, you know. So you know, we're in and out of the trunk one day, and now we don't know who bent it. You know, I'm saying he did it. He said I did it and wasn't paying attention. How do you know I did it? You know? So no one was blaming. I mean, it just was an unfortunate thing. So that was the only 36-inch channel that Willie has ever made after that, because it wasn't practical and wasn't usable back then, because Willie just started designing these tools. So based on what I know now and what Willie knows now with his trials and errors, he made it possible. Because I understand it, I've made it possible. Because 6 more inches wouldn't really hinder my ability to stick and move. I've come to the conclusion of that. Back then, it wouldn't have been possible for me to clean the window efficiently without ragging the heck out of the framework, you know, because of all the corners it missed. But now, well, you know, I discovered dog earing, and that's the key when you're using such a large, wide body, thin channel like Wagtail. You have to dog ear the ends when you start getting longer, you know. So 36 inch, I think I could use that efficiently. I don't know about getting all crazy and doing vertical wagging and all this nonsense, but with a big channel like that, you don't have to do that. It eliminates that because it has a large coverage area. And you like Louie, you know, Louie be knocking out stuff with that 40-inch sorbo or 56-inch sorbo. That sucker was like damn almost 3 feet. Louie don't play around, you know. Some of you are lost way before y'all get to this point, because this is a long video all in itself. But Wagtail, I was genieing with a, let's put it this way, I was genieing with a 30-inch Wagtail. You know, because my 36-inch went to crap. So I had bought another one, a 30-inch. And I was knocking out stuff, man. I wasn't that boy to play with. My boss saw my potential. And I worked my way up from being the worst employee to the best employee. And he wanted me to get into management and this and that. And I did every facet of the business. I was taught how to clean windows at that company. I learned everything. So I owe that man a dedication. I go back from time to time. I showed him some of the ideas that I was working on with, you know, my little projects and stuff. You know, he was excited. I said I was trying to get him to incorporate his guys into using it in the genie. They won't have to lug that 5-gallon bucket around in the genie chair. But if anybody's a genie guy and you'd be interested in hearing what I have to say, you know, holler at me. Or if you know your boss, man, I'll get you set up. I'll tell y'all exactly what's going on. And then when I update it and upgrade it, y'all see, trust me. But I'm going to work on the previous company I used to work for. I'm going to try to sell my idea to them and give them the first crack at trying to see what it could do as far as performance and putting ease on the actual worker itself in general, but still perform the same results. I think most bosses would want to put their men at ease and make their job easier, but still produce the same results, if not even better. But since it got rained out, I did some laundry, and I'm going to do my weekend, because I've been slacking lately with this, weekend M.A.W.'s, rocking with M.A.W. So if there's any suggestions, then feel free. But other than that, for Sunday, I mean, today is going to be too late by the time some of y'all watch this video, but today I'm doing reggae. See you look a bleach. See you use a bleach on the skin. See you use a bleach. Me look like a brownie. Me tell it at the yo. I use a bleach on the skin. See you no chemicals. You look like a brownie. I said a permanent. I drop up and down my number. A permanent. So some of the black and some of the white, some of the black and some of the white, some of the love the ganja, somebody called why? Jump, say no, do it. I'll move ya. Body di di. I got my dance in another country. I oversized waffle wire. Do it. I rock a muffin dance wire. Do it. I jump the bubble down that pass a wire. Do it. I land a piece of that wire. Do it. Summer do it and I landed and the summer knee. And then when we do it wisely. So kitchen and up and I kitchen my knee. And this is the way we do it, New York City. We go permanent. I jump by my double. And some of the black, so some of the black and some of the white, some of the black and some of the white, some of the lovely ganja, some of the hard wire. All right, this is Masters at Wagtail. Come back, rocking with M.A.W.'s and M.A.W. compilation, all rolled into one. Macca fracka lacka. Peace, peace, peace.
What you saying now?